Welcome to the first in a series of TypeScript for C# developers videos, starting with let and const. In C#, today's most common way of declaring a variable would be with var. So we can go num likes is 100 and do console.writeline num likes. Save that, run the script, and we get 100. Very good. In TypeScript, var is highly discouraged, so most people would recommend you use let for something like this. 100, console.num likes, and we can run the app and it says 100. Very good. So obviously num likes can be changed. 200, run the app, 200, and here we can go num likes is 200. Very good. So if we didn't want to be able to change the value of num likes in C#, we'd use a constant. However, there is a limitation in C# where you actually have to declare the type here. Now you can't change a value of num likes after setting it. In TypeScript, it's a similar concept. You can make something a constant, and then it won't let you change the value afterwards. In TypeScript, if you wanted to use a default value for a variable, you could do let num subs and write console.log num subs. So let's see what this prints out. 100 and undefined. By using let, you don't have to provide a value. The equivalent in C# would be something like this, num subs. Problem here is that you can't declare var num subs. You have to provide a default value. And then console.writeline would be 0, of course. You can't do the same thing in TypeScript. You can't just say that this is a number, because as soon as you try to use it, it will throw an error saying variable numSubs is used before being assigned. So to fix this then, you would then have to provide a default value. One more thing they have in common is that you can't rely on a default value for a constant in C#, throws an error, and likewise, consts in TypeScript also have to be initialized. So in summary, constants must be initialized and cannot change later, and use let for something that doesn't necessarily have to be initialized and can change later. Cheers.